Today, 48, inside the house, Dr. Evil still reigns. Outside the house, Hip Hop Man meets Hip Hop Man. This is Big Brother's Little Brother. Do you subscribe to that scripture? Hang on a second, boys. Oh, for the love of God. Oh, yeah. Welcome to Big Brother's Little Brother. Utterly loving your work already. Keeping it up, big guy. Well, coming up on today's show, keep going, big fella. There's a week of dancing in the house. Hip hop ledge Coolio judges who has the best grooves there with Goss and is going to be rapping with Goss on this very show. Yes, indeed. And relationship expert Jenny Trent News on why Nish and Scott flirty antics are all a big act. I can't be right. Is that right? Tell me it's not right. But we'll kick off as we always do. Little Brother's Big News. Oh, yeah. At 11:48 this morning, Ray did this week's task all on his lonesome. He had to gamble a shopping budget of £51 on a single spin of a roulette wheel. He only put £1 on black, and this is what happened.
Look over the Irish, bring home the bacon. Maybe not.
Too quick. Too quick.
So, the shopping budget for this week is all of £2. Ray has ordered one toilet roll. That's not going to be nice when that baby runs out. Four tins of chopped tomatoes. See the old Bible going to good use then, I'll tell you. One tin of sweet corn and he's pushed the boat out on two carrots. Now, yesterday at 3:17, four chickens tried to make their way into the house. Ray wasn't having any of it and shooed them away. But these little chucks weren't giving up that easily. At 9:41 this morning, one black and white and one speckled chicken and another grey one. Give it another go.
I mean, heck, cheat of that, animals.
And finally, it's time for Beard Watch. Despite complaining yesterday that his beard was, and I quote, itchy, Cameron seemed very proud of it this morning at 9:27. Take a look at this.
Have you seen Robinson Crusoe the day?
Who's that?
Me, you and my old hairy chin.
Interesting. Now, let's compare Cameron's facial hair growth to Scott's. Very interesting. Both looking quite, well, a bit weary there, it has to be said. But both looking quite happy about the Robinson Crusoe-esque style of the facial hair. But it's not just the boys who are a bit of in for a bit of follicle stimulation. Have a look at this.
I'd still call you with a beard. I quite
like
having a bit of
think
I'm having a beard.
Heard it from her first. Apparently, she wants a beard for the leprechaun outfit, so we will indeed keep an eye on that and wish she gets her very own crock of gold. For now, that was Little Brother's Big News. Okie dokes, it appears that Cameron, Lisa and Steph are all up for eviction this week, but what have they done to amuse us lately? Well, Cameron's been busy making catty comments. Lisa's just entertainment all the way, and Steph, she's been bringing out them big guns, cleaning. Let's remind ourselves.
Well, I have to be honest, I don't like it.
That's exactly the
what that she said.
Because it's rising.
Shut up. I'm going to the diary room.
We're worrying because she could win.
If I hear one more time about this breathlessness, I think I'll put my own thumb over the top of her windpipe.
I do not look like this normally. I dress to kill. My memory is my best thing. I've got the most superb memory. I know Goss is a chef and I'll never be his level, but I'm a good cook, very good cook. I could kill somebody with those two fingers.
So how does it all get so filthy? Is it okay if I just quickly back in here? Because it does look a bit mucky.
Well, I do like it to be clean.
With that in mind, and I never say that, so with that in mind, today's cool BBLB is, if you were Big Brother and you could, who would you keep in and why? interesting. These are numbers to call. Oh, it is not often the housemates have a chance to get down to some fat beats. This week it's been all about the music, however, with the likes of Cisco's Thong Song waking the house up every morning, and you choose With or Without You, keeping them rocking in the rewards room. With that in mind, hip-hop star and Big Brother fan Coolio is here, and here to talk about his, who can bust the best moves and who can't, along with the Vic T. Goss, everyone.
Yeah! Oh! How are you?
Look at the effect he's had on Goss already! It's amazing! Wonderful. First of all, Coolio, you've been watching a lot of Big Brother. You've been in the country about 3 weeks, haven't you? You've been watching a fair bit of Big Brother.
Well, I used to. I was watching last year when I was here as well.
Okay, so with that.
And the year before that.
This year, who would you keep in?
Right now, the people, the people that are left.
Yep.
Do I have to pick somebody to leave?
Yeah, no, you want to pick someone to stay this week. Lisa, Steph, and Cameron.
Oh, I'd go out, Steph.
Yeah, you like Steph, don't you?
Well, you know, she's different from all the other girls. Her look is different. You know, her attitude is a little different. You know, I'm into people being different.
Absolutely. Me too.
You know.
Give us that. Right. I want to be Coolio's pal. Right, I want to talk about which of the housemates can shake their body the best, guys. First up, we've got... Thanks, mate. Okay, nice touch. It wasn't very cold. Okay, first up, we've got Scott and Cameron dancing to a bit of pop. S Club 7's Don't Stop Moving. Are you aware of that song? You know? No. Okay, cool. Well, they were dancing to it on day 44 at 8:59. Let's take a look. I'm looking at that and I'm thinking embarrassing uncle at wedding. What are you thinking? Can those boys move at all?
I'm thinking drunk uncle priest at wedding.
Drunk uncle priest at wedding? Goss, can those boys, in your opinion, can those boys move?
I'm thinking uncle, auntie, cousins, all drunk at the wedding.
Everyone's drinking at that wedding. I'd love to be there. Okay, so that's a definite no. Next up, we've got Nush, Ray, Scott and Steph doing a traditional kind of Irish jig on day 44 at 8:17 p.m. Take a look at this. Now, interesting, and the thing that slightly freaks me out is that even though Ray is Irish, he can't even do an Irish jig. But they're Nush and Steph, yeah, the girls.
Yeah.
Do you think?
I thought that Nush and Scott was high.
Oh really?
Yeah, they was at least they was kicking high.
Yeah.
You gotta get your feet up, kicks.
Yeah. Yeah. But Steph there, I mean, I know you like her and she's different and stuff, but kick wise.
No, she was fine. She was fine. She put a little hip into it.
Oh, they'll wiggle. We love a bit of that. Okay, and finally...
Wiggle, jiggle, shake, shake, pop.
I subscribe to that. Okay, and finally, at day 45, 11:45, the same four took to the dance floor for the last dance. Take a look at this. I don't know if you're familiar with the whole concept of a last dance over here at a youth club or a nightclub or something. People essentially just get together with the one they want to grope the most.
Who was the guy in the white T-shirt?
Was that Ray there in the white T-shirt?
It was Raymondo, yeah.
No,
that was Scotty Too Hotty.
Okay, Scott, that'd be Scott.
Yeah. Scott is corny, man. Scott is...
What do you mean corny? Just
the way he was moving is just corny.
Yeah.
It looked like, you know, it's just corny.
Have you ever done any gigs up in Liverpool?
Yeah.
That's where he's from.
Yeah, he just... Well, people in Liverpool are actually not corny.
No, they're not corny at all.
It's just... It's real. Maybe it's just Scott.
Maybe I
just don't really like Scott's T-shirt.
Okay, cool. Lovely. Is this all right for you?
Actually, no. Let me tell you what it is. See, this is the thing about in the UK. You guys wear your T-shirts and your shirts, like, way up here. Like,
yeah.
It's supposed to be like
that. No, man, just stretch it.
It's supposed to be like that, though.
That's yeah, well, you're wearing a vest. What are you talking about?
No, but it's supposed to be like that.
Okay.
But see... You know, y'all be, and then I see guys put a pack of cigarettes in their sleeve and
stuff. Yeah. I ain't in the NAM.
That's way superintendent.
Okay, well, I won't wear this ever again.
No. That's your style.
Okay, cool. Thanks, buddy. So, overall, who do you think's got the best rhythm?
Steph. Ooh, we are like girls. Steph.
Yeah?
Thank you.
Okay, cool. Now, Goss, we're not going to judge you.
Ray's
pretty good. Yeah. Right? Okay, Joss, we're not going to judge you, but you're very into your hip-hop, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so much so. You even chose to be hip-hop man for the superhero task about 3 weeks ago. Here's a reminder, Coolio, of what he was like.
Wiki, wiki, wee! Here we go. My
Space in the kitchen, John.
That look is brilliant.
Platinum. Didn't
have
anything.
What were we thinking there, Claudia?
Are you going to be hip-hop man with no diamonds?
They did not give us the stuff. No, there's no bling.
Anyway, we want Goss to have the chance to rap with a true and like a true master. And because we aim to please, we've asked Coolio if he'd do the honours. He's very kindly agreed to, so in a minute we're going to be sending them both off to come up with a rap together. But first, stick around for today's music poll. One of Ray's leadership duties this week includes choosing a different song to wake the housemates up to each morning. Each week, we're giving you a list of four songs. You have to pick two. The highest number of votes are given to Ray to choose from. Yesterday, you voted for Nelly's Hot In Here and Busted's Year 3000. Ray plumped for Nelly being Hot In Here, piped into the house this morning, and this is what happened. Okay, so here's today's list of four songs and four humiliating dances. First of all, it's Gabrielle's Rise. Look in my life, look in my heart, I had seen the fall apart. Now I'm ready to rise. Everyone did that when they were 12. There we go, it's the old pretend kiss. Next up, Sugar Bay's Free Like Me. Okay, song C is Sophie Ellis-Bextor's Murder on the Dance Floor. It's murder on the dance floor, but you better not kill the broom. Hey, it's murder on the dance floor. And the classic Ronan Keating, you have to pick this one day. Love's Roller Coaster, let's hear it. So, which song do you want Raimondo to choose from? For Gabrielle's Rise, text poll A to 85444. Sugar Bay's Freak Like Me, poll B to 85444. Sophie Ellis-Bextor's Murder on the Dance Floor, poll C to 85444. And Ronan Keating's Life is a Roller Coaster, text poll D to 85444. Text cost 25, please. Okay, after the break, we find out if Coolio can teach Goss how to rap. Yeah, I know you can. It's just suspension of disbelief, isn't it? Plus, relationship expert Jenny Trent Hughes explains why Nish and Scott are just flirting with the cameras. Peace out, see you in two. Making a couple of notes there. Welcome back to today's show tonight. Ray will once again choose a Big Brother to play into the house, a tune to play into the house tomorrow morning at 9. Today, you've been voting for two tracks who'll be chosen from. In second place, with 28%, is the Sugar Babes. And 52%, you get us, we get you. It's a good relationship. That's why 2 million people watch Ronan Keating. Hey! Come on, all night long. Hey! All night long. Okay, I'm talking to Ray. This is what he said on day 46, 9:07 p.m. Do you think there's something going on that we don't know about between these two? He was, of course, talking about between Nush and Scott, as everyone is right now. Let's have a look at the story so far.
Do you want to start? Mushing it up with your hand.
If we both do it, it'll be like something out of Ghost. Do you ever see yourself with anyone long term?
Yeah. I'd like to see myself with someone soon.
Because you're a very nice guy.
Yeah, whatever. There you go. And time
goes by. You have to come around my house.
Yes.
Meet the folks.
You need to have more dreams about you. I only had two last night. Yeah.
We want it to happen. In the BBUK office, half of us think they genuinely fancy each other. The other half think it's all an act. Relationship expert Jenny Trent Hughes knows all about this kind of thing. So she's going to be able to tell us which is right. Jenny, welcome to the show. Do they fancy each other?
They fancy each other possibly in a sexual sense.
Yeah.
But as far as real love, no. You see, there's affection, and then there's sex, and then true love is when you have sex and affection.
Oh, don't. That's look, not yeah, fair. I know you're spelling out all the problems with every relationship I've ever had. okay, so, I mean, why not? I mean, on the what's the deal on the surface?
Okay,
what you
first of all, you know, let's be clinical here. Historically speaking, Scott has paid not too much attention to Nush. It's just that now that there's no one else there, he looks up and thinks, okay, she's not too bad. She has cozied up to every single man who has been in that house so far. She, in all the Big Brothers I've watched, she's the only person who's managed to do it and not be labeled a flirt or anything else. So it's now his turn to be cozied up to.
She's doing a great job then, isn't she, really?
Oh, absolutely, because she puts on this little sort of baby voice and says, ooh, I'm drunk, and, you know, gets away with it.
She sold me.
Yeah, well, exactly.
Okay, well, so... What is the game they're playing? I mean, you know, is Scott... Do you think Scott's coming out well out of this? Because obviously she is.
Okay, I don't think it's a conscious game that they're playing. But now they're heading towards the home stretch. So whatever your calling cards are that you've been holding on to, you've got to lay them on the table now. So everybody's personality is going to start being bigger than it's been so far.
Okay, well, let's have a look at the body language in detail. Let's take a look at this. Now, see, for me, I mean, this is relatively innocuous to start with, yeah? He tells her to shush, and then they get a bit kind of a slightly more touchy feeling. Now, that for me says she's warm for his form.
Oh, right, okay.
Yeah. You just did that to me, I know. But that's...
No, but you see, for example, their hands, look at her hands. Her hands are covering up her personal areas. Mm. Her body is leaning away from him.
Yeah.
You know, his legs are quite close. There's a lot of distance between them.
Okay.
And the eye contact, they don't look at each other for long periods of time. So there's sexual touching, because I've been watching it a lot during the day. Lots of sexual touching, but as far as genuine, you know, heart beating, it's just not happening.
So very briefly, how can you genuinely tell when people fancy each other?
Lots of eye contact, lots of wanting to be next to each other, like you and me, and that kind of thing. When you'll also notice that Nush puts her hands across her body a lot when she's... When, you know, when she's with him, turns away from him a lot. Those are signs that she isn't really emotionally attracted to him.
Sure thing. Okay, how far do you think they'll play this game?
I think they will go very, very far, because I think that the both of them are very crafty. I don't believe this nice, innocent business on either one of them. So I think that they will. They could get naked. I don't think, you know, will occur, but I think they could get naked.
Interesting. Okay, we want to find out how far Nush's mum, Liz, thinks her daughter will go. Not like that. She's on the phone now. Hello, Liz.
Hello, Dermot.
How are you? All right?
I'm fine, thank you.
So how will Nush and Scott get it on? Will they?
I don't know whether they'll get it on. I think there's a bit of a friendship forming there. I think they do like each other. I agree with some of the things Jenny says. Whether Nush is playing tactics, I don't know. She's like that with all her male friends. That's just the way she happens to be. She's comfortable in male company, and we're very huggy and tactile. I'm an ex-nurse, so she's got that from me. We hug and we touch people a lot, and I think that's just part of her.
Very honest of you.
Pardon?
That's very honest of you. I like that.
Well, that's the truth.
Okay, brilliant. Thank you very much. Do you think that maybe... Has she got a boyfriend or not right now? Because I'm a bit... That's a bit of a grey area.
She has got a boyfriend, but he's away at the moment, working.
Navy.
So we've not had a lot of contact with him. I don't really know how he feels about everything. I think he's pretty cool.
Yeah.
But I don't know what the relationship's going to be like at the end of all this. We'll just have to wait and see.
Liz, thank you very much. Jenny, thank you very much as well. Okay. Goss and Coolio spent some time now behind the scenes, coming up with a rap song about... the time, well, about the house, pretty much. They're back to perform it right now. I am going to be kind of faux DJing for them, which I'm very much looking forward to. Gentlemen, hello there, how are you? I'm MC Derm, nice to meet you both. If you
hello,
would indeed.
DJ, you're the DJ.
Yeah, absolutely.
Well,
sorry,
so you're DJ
Derm. I'm the DJ Derm, yeah. Beg your pardon, Coolio. Right, go for it.
Yo.
Big G.
What's up, Coolio?
You want to break them up, some big bro style,
I'm ready,
man?
I'm ready to break it up.
All right, go on. Do it.
Yeah. It's a GOS,
of course
I'm fresh. I'm from the BB4. Do you want more?
Yo.
Big G is in the house
now.
I'm at home with a girl on the
couch now.
When I start rapping, my mate
start clapping. Look, I'm on telly.
Yo, and I'm rapping.
The next time you see me, ask me what happened. I went from big bro to big breast, lights, camera, action. Yeah.
Wonderful. OK, the guys are sticking around for funny, but right now, catch up of today's news. Take a look at this.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
The housemates have a shopping budget of just £2 this week after Ray gambled badly in a solo toss this morning. Two chickens made it into the house today for the first time ever, but not for long once Cameron clapped his eyes on them. And Beard Watch continues, with Scott and Cameron cultivating some impressive facial growth after 6 days of no shaving. That was absolutely great. Cheers, boys.
Thank you, sir.
Appreciate it. Good work, Claudio. OK, today's phone-in, quite simply, is if you're a big brother, who'd you keep in-house and why? I don't think we've got much time, so let's just whisk through them. Janet from Wigan. Hello, Janet.
Hello, Dermot.
You all right?
Hi, Goss.
Hiya.
Coolio. I'll see you when you get there.
Thanks. OK, so who would you keep in then, huh?
Lisa.
Really?
Most definitely.
Why Lisa?
Because she's good entertainment, she's brilliant, she's funny, she's shaping the house up. And the thing is, it's tactical now. We've got to split Cameron and Steph up.
Really?
Hans got to go. Definitely.
Gosh, you're
Hans got to go. He's sneaky, slice too fast. Keep Lisa in the house.
Cameron's thinking about that, though, isn't he?
I'm not bothered.
No, he's got to go.
What are you thinking?
I'm thinking Lisa's given us 2 weeks of entertainment. It's time for Lisa to move on. Next week's going to be funny. It's going to be a lot harder because they're going to be back to normal. They're going to be their mates and they're going to have to nominate each other and it's going to be a lot more interesting. We don't need Lisa no more.
Mm-hmm. Okay,
hasta la vista.
Thanks a lot, Janet. Andy from Lincoln. Hey, Andy.
Hello there, DJ Dermot.
Go for it.
Well, if I was Big Brother of the day, I would definitely keep Cameron in the house.
Keep Cameron in?
Yeah.
Why so?
Well, we would say, you know, he's not only the last gentleman in the country, I think he's probably the last gentleman we've got left as well.
Oh, you're strong. Very strong. OK, mate, thank you very much. Lastly, Jill from Camberley. Hey, Jill.
Oh, hi, Dermot.
Hiya, how are you?
I'm fine, and you?
Only got about 20 seconds left on this, so you go for it.
Right, I'm going to say let's get Lisa to stay. Sorry, Goss, but we love her. Come Friday, eviction night, the friction in that house would be absolutely fantastic. Keep Lisa in.
Brilliant. Thank you very much. OK, pretty much all we've got time for on the phones today. You know the numbers that count, and these are they. And out on the flight case here, it looks like I'm just some sort of pop star myself. OK, so we've got time for thanks to Coolio, Jenny Trent News, Anne and Goss. Don't forget, join us tomorrow at 6. Karen Taylor and Tim Vine from The Sketch Show are going to be our guests. Big Brother tonight at 10. See you tomorrow.